After hours of number spreadsheets and budget jargon, lawmakers from around South Dakota climb onto a bright white bus. The seats are cushy, but the bus is hot and sticky this late June day. The ride begins with chatter and energy, but the atmosphere transforms as the wheels roll past picturesque homes and into entire neighborhoods surrounded by sandbags.
It's remarkable the human effort, I think, that's gone into this.
The bus pushes past orange and white barricades that scream for people to stay back. State Senator Phyllis Heineman is from Sioux Falls. This is her first time seeing the swollen Missouri River.
You look at those houses and you think, boy, just how badly they're hurting, and that it's going to be months before they kind of know what the full impact is.
Lawmakers peer out the windows as each city street begins with law enforcement regulating who gets in.
We did credentialing system for everybody that's in potentially affected areas.
And ends with an earthen berm and scattered sandbags, the mighty Mo looming just on the other side of the barrier. From the high seats of the bus, legislators can see the glistening water on the other side.
I was just amazed at all of the dirt work that had been accomplished in a short time period. The total massive focus on protecting people and homes and how the community came together to protect not only the infrastructure but their individual homes.
State Senator Larry Tiedemann serves constituents in Brookings, and he says this opportunity to see the plight in the central part of the state proves South Dakotans' perseverance and focus on community. Still, he is an appropriator, and as Tiedemann witnesses guard patrols and heavy machinery, he can't help but think of the burgeoning costs.
And now we're looking at, $5 million for cost just for sandbags, for helicopters, another $1.5 million. And you start adding it all up, and it's huge. And we're not done yet, because once the water starts to go down, you have to remove all of this material.
Tiedemann isn't alone in looking ahead to additional work that brings additional bills as the bumpy journey takes him along the river from Pierre into Fort Pierre. Representative Dean Wink chairs the Joint Appropriations Committee.
This is just the leading edge of what we may be seeing, because they're saying that the high water is going to last for a month or two.
Wink comes from Howe, South Dakota, but his vote represents all South Dakotans when appropriations tackles the state budget. Wink keeps that perspective as he surveys the stout levees and rides past dozens of homes inundated with water.
There's so many things iffy right now. FEMA can reimburse the state and the communities up to 75% federal, and hopefully that'll happen. And then the 10% will be borne by the state and 15% by the communities.
Wink says legislators will know more by the next appropriations meeting in October. Instead of wondering how much of the financial burden South Dakota faces, lawmakers will know more about what the federal government will reimburse.
You know, we are in much better shape than most states, because when they have natural disasters, a lot of them don't have reserves or rainy day funds, and we do. So I'm sure that they'll be called upon to try and help out to get communities and the state, you know, back in order.
As the bus accelerates toward the state capitol, the flood-stricken communities shrink in the driver's rearview mirrors. The short, smooth ride offers lawmakers a few minutes of reflection.
I had an idea, but you don't really realize the impact until you're here and see it firsthand, and it's going to be huge, but we'll work our way through it.
Just as property owners surrounded by water, these lawmakers know they won't fully understand the impact of flooding until the Missouri River creeps back into its banks and the unparalleled crisis finds a place on the ledger. For South Dakota Public Broadcasting, I'm Keely Boltina.